guys. I think it's Kevin. We are the research partners at NYCPC, which is a corporation. And we're here to talk about the analysis of some MTA Turnstile data that we did. Basically, the MTA publishes week-long blocks of Turnstile counts, entries and exits at every station. It's on the website. It's not very well advertised that it's there, possibly because it's kind of badly formatted and just not that easy to use, which is something we ran into when we decided to start working. The turnstile counts are done at 4-hour intervals, except for when the turnstiles mess up and there's all kinds of problems there that we had to get through. But eventually, we actually got into a usable format. It's slightly more than 40 million records, about 3 gigabytes in size, did its data. We had to difference these running counts in order to get counts for every 4-hour period. And then for every station, we did morning and evening counts because we were interested in making a ratio between the office residential ratio, which basically is the mornings over evenings entries in order to see what the dynamics are of how people use that station. So what we saw is that if people use the cutoff there was which makes sense. But however, some stations that were in central business districts, which we also mapped, actually turn out to have fairly low ratios, which we found was really interesting. And we ended up having that And that's kind of what it looks like. The blue is low ratios, the white is close to one. The red is high ratios, as you can see, the town of Manhattan is holding them. As you get further out, you get more red, and then as you get hot, not at least like hot, Brooklyn, that are pretty the black circles are just absolute counts of morning plus evening entries, just to give an idea of how much stations are.
A couple of visualizations would just go too much. So there's a ratio on low ratios on the low end, on the left, higher on the right. We wanted to check on this ratio. Kind of had our gut check, but we wanted something a little more concrete. So we're using some zoning data, and zone C5 or C6, so there's your high-rise, your high-density, mixed-use, storage space. And then we just kind of hand-coded a 1 or 0, if it's a business district, if it's in one of these highly commercial zoned areas. And so that was a good sign for our ratio. We see some anomalies there, especially Midtown South, along with that city. Areas are not zoned as high-density commercial areas. So that's the gray lines they're going to. And then some areas on the right, like Jamaica, 45th Street in Harlem. These are zoned as that way, but the subway data shows them as a more residential zone. And this, I can go through very fast. This is just an attempt at taking these stations and putting it in the neighborhood level. These are actually special districts from the city planning department. This is our starting point. One of our next steps is just put them into true neighborhoods.
It's so weird.
And some next steps. These are the special districts. We want to have every surprise station in the neighborhood, and that's in process. We're using some coding for that.
So every time
centroids for each neighborhood. And we're going to do some time series, some other ways to look at business activity other than just this kind of like office with office workers. And then also, especially in Jamaica, the outer buildings, we're interested in Long Island Railroad and driving in and how this is going to affect the subway data.
To other ways people
Yeah, somewhat. I mean, at the beginning of the project, we started with a kind of city-wide and data level. We were looking at bus data and so on. And then we zoned in and we really just wanted to focus on MTA data. But there's a lot of interest in trade. Maybe like I said, it's no one in the business district is very residential. I think our ratio is showing it as more residential than it is. It's a theory. Because people will move from Long Island and enter the subway system in the morning. So that's the next step.
So in terms of actually looking at it over time, we have tried to then correct for outliers and outliers. Those things definitely show up. Things like Hurricane Sandy obviously show up, but July 4th or whatever, that's...
we have time series that takes on some other stuff. We haven't done, that would be an interesting study. That's come up just in the fact that as we looked at the time series and said, oh, there's weird stuff. But that would be an interesting study. We did think about Atlantic Center, Barclay Center. You can see where we work is heavily involved in that project, so we thought it might be interesting to see how the subway uses has changed since the Barclay Center. This data goes back to June 2010. So I think people are interested.
I know EDC, you guys use a lot of census data too. Do you see it correlate with what the census is with public transport?
I did a little bit of that. It's just the aggregated citywide level. I was looking at population and jobs. We do a lot with jobs data. I didn't get too far on that. One of the reasons is population is something that's it's only really fully counted every 10 years. And then they do annual estimates based on their and the time span for that is just a lot longer. But it does appear some early checks that I did that population growth and subway usage growth correlated jobs. The subway usage fluctuated with jobs, which I found very interesting.
So I'm gonna talk about taxis, because I'm a taxi guy.
Yeah.
And I looked at 1 week as a sample, so if anyone wants something to look at, this was pretty interesting. I looked at 1 week, but comparing the Turnstile data, so I looked at First Avenue in East Village compared to taxi pickups within a quarter mile, sort of like the catch area of that station. And I looked at it by time, day of week, and to see the modal split, like the weekday, morning rush, evening rush, but then the Saturday, 4 a.m., like over 50% of those people are getting in a taxi, not taking the subway, but then sort of the house function was really interesting. You know, I have more time with the subway to go to the
center. Yeah, hope that you do. Our ratios use weekday only, and those morning and evening time blocks. We've got the final slide, there's a GitHub address. I love to heavily annotate code. It's data code. It's really exciting. All of you are eager to jump in this data, I'm sure. We're excited about it. Hey, it's data. It's new expression. But I put lots of notes in there for every choice that we make.
I would say very
good. I'm interested to see what we call this behind the
server. There's this thing. Why your ratios
I think initially we were just kind of like, what is every station look like in the evening versus the morning? And then once we looked at it, we were like, well, it's really hot. It's going to be around the morning.
The process was a little backwards at the beginning. We
this is our core story. So find a data set, see what that tells us. The research question, but this was early on, I think, like, this is what we're involved in. Hotel, we'll do a lot of jobs.